Yeah. They'll probably make her run once in a while too, but that's not the thing. Doing all right?
Yeah.
Changed her major a couple times. That's history pre-law right now. Got herself a significant other down there. A bit old, it's out of the business.
She was right
on. Yeah, I said. That's a tumor, right? Amy's off her clerk. Just graduates.
I'm not even making it. Good evening, and welcome to our Music in Our Schools concert. March is Music in Our Schools Month every year, and it always is a very exciting month for our student musicians. March is the month that we have our large youth festival over in Rice Lake. It is also the month that we have this concert, and then we have our school musical in March every year. It's kind of an odd grouping of ensembles that you're going to hear tonight. If you're wondering why, this is how it works. The ensembles that participate in the large group festival in Rice Lake alternate in our district, and they performed Monday. And then the groups that do not perform at large group festival then perform at this concert. So you always have a mix of high school and middle school ensembles. And you're in for a real treat tonight because all of the groups are super well prepared and have fun selections. This concert will be rather brief. It looks like there's a lot of music on there, but it is less than an hour. So I kindly ask that you sit and enjoy the entire concert, and if possible, get off your phones and don't record it. Live music, as we have figured out in the last couple of years, is really a rare thing. And so you have the opportunity tonight to just sit here, enjoy your students making music live in the moment, and that is an experience that is worth sharing, not looking through a screen, just my personal opinion. I would like to thank all the music faculty and all of our wonderful students for working very hard this quarter. I'd like to thank our accompanist, Mrs. Rodmaker, for being here tonight, and thank all of you for being here. And without further ado, it is my honor to start with something great.
Thank you. Early evening again. That first piece that they played is called Equinox by an American composer by the name of Ed Huckabee. The reason we picked that piece is it has a variety of tempos and it's in a key signature that the band is not used to playing, and it goes slow and fast and then it ends fast again. And I need to write a script because now I'm bumbling my words, I apologize. But anyway, so that was considerably harder than the stuff that they were playing in December. The next two pieces are also a variety of things. The next piece we're going to play is called African Adventure. You're going to hear some call and response things within the sections of the band. Again, it's in a different key signature than they're used to playing in, so that was another learning tool that we used, and this is another reason why we picked this piece. So with that, this is called African Adventure. They've been great, and I hope you can hear their improvement throughout the year, and we're looking forward to our final concert, which will occur towards the end of May. So with that, we're going to play our last piece, and then we're going to turn it over to one of the choirs. Thank you.
Thank you. Tate by Brian Tate. Not Tate. Anyway, Gati Gati is actually a Sanskrit text which comes from a Buddhist teaching. And Gati can mean many things. It can mean gone from forgetfulness to mindfulness, or from suffering to liberation. And it's a statement of growth of an individual. It can be used as a mantra, and it's a difficult piece to memorize, and you have to pay really close attention to the meter. So we really worked hard this quarter working on meter and making sure that we changed with, because this goes from 6-8 to 2-4 to 3-4, and then we go to 7-8 and back into 6-8. So we really had to work hard at this piece. And also, it repeats the same words over and over and over, but it uses them in different ways. So memorization was really hard.
Gate, gate, para, gate, para, some gate, bodhisattva.
Thank you.
choir member that had passed at the Fergus Falls Minnesota Choir Program. And it really expresses the way individuals find places and things to remember people of importance in their life that have passed on. There's Latin in the middle, and it loosely translates, grant them eternal rest and let their light shine forever. Lux perpetua.
Lead with
meant to thank Renee Rodemaker for playing for us tonight. We picked her up because we lost Tam to the Spooner musical, so we can give her a little round. It's in a mixed meter, and it's also in Latin. And Latin is really good for developmental singing because it only has pure vowels. In English, we have a lot of diphthongs, and we even have triphthongs. It's kind of crazy because we take our language from so many other languages. But in Latin, we only have 5 pure vowels. And the translation of this one is a religious text. It's "Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, come before his presence with singing. For the Lord is good, and his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth for all generations." Generationem.
night is restless with the sounds we hear, is broken, shaken by the cries of pain. For this is music sinner calls, saying, yes, we hear you. All you who cry aloud, and we will fly, answering you so loud.
Ooh.
Start with Get Ready. Thank you very much for attending this evening.